nothing but killing of one's sister. Okay, so killing of one's sister is called as sororicide. Okay, yes, so sorority, like sorority is related to your sister. Or when I say that, you know, sorority is something like, you know, you have an organization maybe in your college or maybe in your school, and that organization is only concerned about women, like, you know, all the women associations that you have. So any in college group, you have an association or a club that is just related to women. It's meant for women. So that you call it as sorority. Okay. Now, uxorious. I just told you about uxorious. Now, uxoricide is killing of one's wife. Now, uxorious is a man who is just going to listen to a woman. Like, whatever she says is going to be patthar ki lakir. So, if I have to tell you in Hindi, uxorious is similar to joru ka gulam. Okay? Whatever the wife says, the person is going to do it. Okay? So, uxorious is joru ka gulam, if I have to explain you in Hindi. But yeah, a man who is going to follow all the commands and instructions of a woman is called as being uxorious. Now, again, uxorial is again related to that. Next word that comes up here is marital. Marital is related to, again, marriage. Now, there are two words that are there, extramarital and premarital. Now, how can anyone tell me the difference between the two? What is the difference between extramarital and premarital? You can use your chat buttons to type in. What's the difference? Okay, having affair before marriage and after marriage. Okay. Okay, yes. So having affair after marriage is going to be extramarital, and premarital affairs se related nahi hai. Like after, so after marriage, you get into some or the other, like, you know, having an affair, or alongside marriage, you are, you know, into a relationship with somebody else. So that is something called as extramarital. When I talk about premarital, it is going to happen before marriage. So both of these things are obligations that the society is not going to accept, something on those lines. So premarital is something that, you know, a woman may be having a child before marriage. So that is something like, you know, you are indulging in a premarital status. So that is something what you call as premarital. Okay. Now, next word that comes up here is regal. Now, what do you mean by regal? Okay. Regal is related to, what does it exactly mean? Is etymologically, it means royal or fit for a king. Okay, so anything that's there, like, you know, your all luxurious activities do you get involved to. So if there is something regalia, so regalia is what do I call about the kingdom wherein each and everything is fit for a king. Okay, so regal means something that is very royal or fit for a king. You get into all the luxurious and luxuries of the life. You take all the luxuries of the life. So that is something what you mean by regal and regalia. Next word that you see here is monomania. Okay. Now, mono means one, mania means you are crazy. Okay. Mad. Okay. So mania is you are crazy behind something. So if you are crazy behind one particular thing only, now that one particular thing could be anything. Okay. So monomania. Okay. If I have to ask you, according to you, what do you mean by monomania? Crazy behind the number one or crazy behind any one particular thing? I hope you got my question. I'm asking you, what according to you is monomania? You are crazy behind any one particular thing or the number one that's there? Okay, okay. Sesh says crazy behind one particular thing. One particular thing. Okay. Yes, so you are, like, you know, so obsessed with something, one particular thing that you have. Maybe it could be your wristwatch, or maybe it could be something that you possess, and you are so crazy behind that, and, you know, you don't want anybody to touch it. You are mad behind that particular thing that's there. That is what you call as monomania. Next word that's there is dipsomania. Okay, now dipso is again related to thirst, and mania is, so if you have the habit of indulging into, like, you know, too much of drinking alcoholic beverages, so that is when you call it, you are a dipsomaniac. Like, you know, day in and day out, all you are doing is, like, just indulging into alcoholic drinking. So if you are that kind of a person, then you would be called as dipsomaniac. Okay, Now, next word, moving ahead, is the word that's called as kleptomania. Kleptomania is one of the conditions wherein, like, you know, you indulge into the habit of stealing. Okay. It's not about because, like, you know, you steal something because you are, yes, you get into robbing. It's not because you don't have money or you don't have that particular thing, but it's just a mental condition that is developed wherein, you know, it forces you to steal something and you enjoy that. So kleptomaniac is going to be someone who gets into a mental condition wherein he loves stealing or, you know, loves robbing, not because of his condition, like not because of his circumstances that's there, but just because of his mental condition. Okay. Yes. So we are done with session number 30. Moving on to session number 31. Before that, anybody has any questions, queries or doubts, feel free to ask. If I am, you all can just use your chat buttons to type in, am I going slow, fast or okay? Feel free to use your chat buttons and type in. My pace is okay, slow, fast. Should I increase the speed or should I continue with the same speed? Okay, Himanshu says go slow, Ronav says speed is okay, so I'll try to go slow and we'll cover ups. Okay, so the agenda is going to be we'll cover up this session and we'll try to cover up few more sessions that are there. We would try to achieve session number 34 or till 35. Okay, so we will also do a quick revision towards the end, so if you are not very well versed with the words that are there, so then you will have a good idea about all the words that's there. Okay, all right. Let's move ahead. If you have any questions, queries, you all can just type in. Okay. Uxorial, somebody asked me. Uxorial. Okay. I'll just. Okay. So I have to go above and check your chats. Just give me a second. Continue with the same speed. Okay. Uxorial, somebody is asking me. Uxorial is something related to your wife. Okay. So uxoricide is killing of one's wife. Uxorious is a man who is following all the commands of women, and uxorial is something that is related to wife. Okay. All right. Let's move ahead. Session number 31 that's there. Okay. Session number 30 word libidinous. What do you mean by libidinous? Now, libidinous is related to, like, you know, any sexual pleasures that are there. So there are a lot of words, in fact, something that is called as leisurely. Okay, leisurely, libidinous, all of these words means related to something related to sexual pleasures. Okay, moving ahead, atheism. Okay, now there are two words that are given here. One is called atheism and the other one is called agnosticism. Okay, now what's going to be the difference between the two? Okay, understand, very important. Okay, atheism. Atheist is going to be a person who doesn't believe that God exists. Okay. So, usko vishwasi nahi hai, kuch bhagwan pe vishwasi nahi hai. He doesn't exist that, you know, he doesn't believe that God exists, hai ki nahi hai, kuch hai hi nahi. There is nothing of that sort, like, you know, God exists, aisa usko lagta hi nahi hai. Now, another person is called as agnostic. What do I mean by agnostic? Agnostic is going to be a person who is not very sure, like, God may exist or God may not exist. So that's going to be the difference between the two. Atheist ko lagta hai, you don't know. And agnostic ko lagta hai, I don't know. But atheist believes that God doesn't exist. Okay. Are you guys clear with the meaning? Now, atheist is going to be the person who believes that, you know, there is no God. God doesn't exist. And agnostic is the person who doesn't know about the existence of the God. So those are the two people that are there. Next word that you can see is polytheism. Now, polytheism is like, you know, people who believe in all the different forces and all the different types of gods that are there. So a person who believes in everything is going to be believes in all gods, like, you know, many gods. In fact, not all gods. All gods will come later. Now you can see a word that's there, pantheism. Now pantheism is a person who is a pantheist is someone who is going to believe in all the gods that are there. And someone who is a polytheist is someone who is going to believe in lot of God, more than one God. Okay, so you have more than you believe in more than one religion, or you believe in more than one God, then you would be called as a polytheist. And if you believe in all religions, all God, then you would be called as a pantheism, pantheist. Okay. Now, monotheism, you just follow one religion, you just follow one God, is going to be a person who is called as a monotheist. Next word that's there is theology. Now, theology means study, and theo means, what do you mean by theo? Okay, theo means again related to God or religion. So theology is going to be the study of gods or study of religion. Okay, am I clear? Next word that's there is satariasis. Okay, now satariasis is again related to sexual pleasures, or men wanting all the sexual pleasures. So the word for that is satariasis. Okay, now there is it is derived from the word that is called a satariomaniacal. Okay, a man who is crazy behind sexual pleasures, he is called as a satariomaniacal. The word for women here is nymphomaniacal. You spell it as NYMPHO. Nymphomaniacal is going to be a woman who is crazy behind all the sexual pleasures. Okay, so those are the two words that are there. Now, the last word that's given in session number 31 is hypochondriac. Okay. Now, what do you mean by a hypochondriac? You might have heard this word. If you all want to type in, just guess. What do you mean by a person who is hypochondriacal? Chondriacal is again going to be a person. Yeah, Sesh, you are right. Worried about health. Even you are ill, you are not ill. Okay, you have that anxiety that's there. You always worried, are meri tabiyat kharab ho jayegi to. Okay, I am not well. You are always cribbing about your own health. Okay, so hypochondriacal is going to be a person who is very worried about his or her own health. That's there. Okay.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from CATKing.